again, I'm Claire. Today I'm going to talk about patterns in number and efficient counting strategies. You will need something to write with, I have a pen, and something to write on, a piece of paper, or even post-it notes will do. In lesson one, we counted lots and lots of things. And if you didn't look at lesson one, you might like to see it now. We learnt that you need to count each thing once. So here I'm going to count my cars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Count each thing once, and the last number you say is the total. The total tells you how many. The order that you count in doesn't matter. I could start with the orange car or the green car, and it would still be 9. Let's try that out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Still 9. So where I start doesn't matter, but I must count each thing just once. The arrangement doesn't matter either. I have the cars in a circle, but I have my trucks in a line. So I can count them in a line as well, and I can count from this side or that side. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I start from this side, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Still 6. So the order or the arrangement does not matter. And the last number that I say is the total. Did you practice some of these things yesterday? Did you count your toys? Did you count your steps? Maybe you made a hundredths chart, because that was another thing we did yesterday. We made a hundredths chart and we looked at all the numbers from 1 to 100. Did you practice some more? Wow, that's fantastic. But if you didn't get a chance, never mind, because we're going to count lots more today. Do you know what I found out yesterday? I found out something really exciting yesterday. I found out you don't always have to count in ones, because I was tidying the shoes. We have a lot of shoes in our house. I was tidying the shoes and I noticed for every one shoe, there's another shoe. And so instead of counting 1, 2, I could go 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. 10 shoes. You can count the shoes in your house sometime too and see, do you have more or less than me? 10 shoes. Now remember, we're able to count backwards as well. I'm going to go 10, 8, 6, 4, and 2. There, all the shoes tidied away. Let me put them on the floor. Counting in twos is really useful when you want to count a big collection of things. So I've got lots of balls in my basket here, and I don't want them all because I want to bring them to a party and I want every child to have one ball. There are 12 children coming to the party, so I want to count out 12 balls, and I'm going to do it in twos. Can you help me? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Fantastic. Let's have a look at those numbers on our number chart. I have got a little green pen here and I'm going to mark off all of those numbers that I used when I'm skip counting. That means I'm counting in twos. So here it is, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. Oh, that's interesting, isn't it? What do you notice about that? Look at that. All my dots are under each other. So I know that everyone in that row has a 2 in it. So let's go onwards. Where were we? We were at 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50. That's how you skip count in twos. If you made your hundreds chart, you can practice that after this lesson. Did you practice saying all the numbers to 100? Did you get better at it? Did you try counting backwards? Did you find a number that was in someone else's head? Did you have a go at counting from the middle? Where's the middle of my numbers chart? If it's 1 to 100, the middle has to be 50. Did you try counting backwards? Let's try counting backwards from 50. 50, 49, 48, 47, 46, 45. Wow, we're good at counting backwards. You can practice that some more this afternoon. Yesterday we wrote down some numbers. Did you practice writing your numbers? I want you to write some numbers on your piece of paper for me right now, okay? So I'm going to ask you to write the number 3. Very good. Can you write 13? Excellent. How about 15? I'm going to ask you a tricky one now. I want you to write 31. 31. Have you written it? Well done. Okay, the last one I'm going to ask you to write just now is 50. Let's check how we went. Do your numbers look like mine? Let's have a go. We wrote the number 3. Did yours look like that? We wrote the number 13. Did you write it like that, with the 1 first and then the 3? That's a tricky number sometimes, and you have to say it very clearly because sometimes people don't hear it right. That's number 13. Let's try number 15. There's number 15. Some people get that one confused as well. That's why you have to say it very clearly. 15. Let's now say, write 31. Oh, 31 looks a lot like 13, doesn't it? But 31 starts with the 3 and then it has the 1 beside it. 31. Let's do our last number. It was 50. Does your 50 look like my 50? Very good. Don't forget, some of these numbers are a bit tricky and you need to say them very clearly so people hear and write the right thing, especially 13, 15, and 50. I'd like you to practice them later today. Very good. All right, now, I've just shown you that I learned to count in twos since the last time we talked, but I learned something else as well. I learned that I don't always have to count. Is that very tricky? I don't always have to count. I discovered this when I was playing a game with my brother. And I discovered that when we threw the dice, I did not have to count the dots on the dice. Here's a dice here. You might have dice at home. Let me throw my dice and show you what I mean. Okay. Oh! I did not count those dots, but I know that there are 5. Did you know there was 5? Let's throw it again and see. Oh, did you have to count that? No, of course not, because it's only 1. Let's throw it again. It's what number is that? 2. Did you count each dot? What? You didn't? You were doing something really special. You were doing something called subitizing. Can you say that word with me? Subitizing. Subitizing is when you know how many without counting every single dot. You just knew that was a six, didn't you? Because six is always a lucky number when you're playing a game, isn't it? Because on the dice, it's the biggest number. Let's subitize some more. Let's see if you can subitize. I'm going to flash you a card and you're going to tell me how many there are. Are you ready? How many on this card? Did you say three? Very good. How many in this one? Did you say four? Very good. How about this one? Oh, it's a three again. Well done. How about? That's a different arrangement. Did you get four? You're right, it is four. What about this one? Oh, it's also four. But it wasn't the same arrangement, and you still knew it. Well done. How about this one? Yes, they were easy. Well done. So subitizing, you may have done this with your teacher before. Subitizing is when you just know it. Sometimes subitizing is a bit tricky. I'm going to do a few more cards, and you can. I'm just going to show them to you for a couple of seconds, and you're going to tell me what number there is. Now, if these things are tricky, you might find that what you do is you recognize a group of dots as being in one number, and then you see some more, and you add them together. So let's have a go at these trickier cards. Are you ready? Did you say five? Well done. What about this one? Also five. Well done. Some subitizing cards are a bit more tricky, and you might make some tricky cards after this lesson. I'm going to show you a few of my tricky cards now. How about this one? Seven. Did you know that was seven? Were you able to subitize? Did you see the six and then the one? Well done. When you make your subitizing cards, you can make them tricky and you can try them out on your family and see, can your family subitize like you can? If you want to practice subitizing, you can play with dice or cards or dominoes. I have taken a pack of cards that you might have cards like this in your house, and I've actually drawn on them. Now, you probably would have to ask permission from your mom or dad if you can do this, but I like to do this so that I don't know the number. So if you can see, I've taken the numbers off and I have to subitize to know that that's an eight, and I know that's an eight. And you can play games with these cards then to practice your subitizing. But there are other games out there that help you to subitize and learn your numbers, like snakes and ladders. Snakes and ladders, you need a dice, and the board that you play on has all the numbers that you need to learn. So you can learn to count forwards and backwards playing snakes and ladders. You might like to play that later today. So after this lesson, I'd like you to practice counting in twos. You can count all your shoes, or you can count everyone in the house's shoes. I would like you to try making your own little subitizing cards. Your post-it notes are perfect for making subitizing cards. I'd like you to practice subitizing using your dice or dominoes or playing cards. And I would like you to keep practicing the hundreds chart. If you didn't make your own the other day, you could make your own or finish your own today. And of course, I would like you to have a bit of fun practicing counting and subitizing by making your own games like snakes and ladders. I will see you in the next lesson.